upon a star. Makes no difference who you are.
My beautiful people, and welcome to the second episode of the Happiest Cast on Earth, the podcast where we review every single film that was released, made, or bought out by the Walt Disney Company in alphabetical order. And I'm here with my guest for this episode. You may know her on TikTok as ForeverKid02, and for viewers of my channel, you may know her as one of the girls that got shot by the Cat in the Hat in the 50th episode of my series, Analogic. Please welcome Katie Lawrence, everyone.
Hi. Thank you for having me here.
No problem. And the film that we shall be talking about today will be The Dale Earnhardt Story. Katie, have you seen this movie before?
Never.
Not once.
Not once.
Neither have I. I am completely unaware about this movie before doing research for this show. But are you aware about the subject of this film?
No.
Well, Dale Earnhardt Sr. was an American NASCAR racer who raced from 1975 to 2001, up till his death, where he ironically died in a racing accident.
Oh, wow.
He's won numerous World Cups, and he's a pretty famous NASCAR racer. I didn't do that much research, honestly. I figured we would learn everything we would need to know about Dale Earnhardt in this ESPN biography. Yes, this was made by ESPN Films, a company that I didn't even know existed till I looked up the Disney film Quita Kadawi, I believe it's pronounced, and it was like ESPN Films, and I learned that ESPN has a film division. And I added all of their films to the list of every Disney movie ever made. Most of it consists of sports documentaries, but films like this, it's a sports biography on a NASCAR driver that neither of us are familiar with at all. So basically, all that really needs to be said is, Katie, are you ready to watch The Dale Earnhardt Story?
Yes, I am.
All right, we'll see you after the movie. Okay, so we just saw The Dale Earnhardt Story. Thoughts?
It was kind of everywhere, actually. Like, a lot of the events happened really quickly and early on in the movie, and they just kept happening. Like, there were no spots where the movie died down. Just stuff kept happening.
Yeah, the movie felt a bit rushed and all over the place for me. Like 17 minutes goes by, and it felt like we were at, like, the end of Act 1 or halfway through the movie.
At the turning point of the story.
It was ridiculous. It's almost like this probably would have been best as a mini-series. Instead of trying to cram, instead of trying to cram, like, 40 years of a man's life into 90 minutes. So, basically, what the film is about, it's about this racer, an inspiring racer named Dale Earnhardt, who is taught to become a racer by his dad, played by J.K. Simmons, who, by the way, is the best part of the movie, who ends up getting killed off about 20 minutes into the film. And Dale ends up becoming a famous NASCAR racer, and he ends up having 4 girlfriends throughout the movie.
3.
Oh, yeah. Oh, there are 3?
Yeah, well, he married two. Wait, no, it doesn't say that he married them. I'm not sure if he did or not, but what I saw was he was with 2 ladies, had children with both of them, and both of them left, and then the 3rd one he got with stayed with him, I'm pretty sure.
Ah, well, so about three girlfriends throughout the entirety of the movie. And we just laughed whenever we're like, dang, man, you broke up with another girlfriend. It's supposed to be a dramatic scene. We clearly were not supposed to laugh at it, but we kept on laughing because it happened so often.
Another one bites the dust.
And Dale, like, the actor who plays Dale kind of looks a lot like a poor man's David Spade. Like, if you put a picture of this actor and a picture of David Spade next to each other, they look pretty freaking similar, I must say. Now, something that I've gradually picked up on is that, Dale's kind of a bit of a dick. Yes. Not the very strict parent, mostly. You know, like, expects the absolute greatest out of his 8-year-old son when he's go-kart racing. Not even real racing, just playing on go-karts. I mean, imagine if you're just playing a fun old game of hopscotch and a drill sergeant being like, what are you doing, maggots? It's F4! Up 2-3-4! Up 2-3-4! What am I paying you for? Bit of a strict parent.
Well, I mean, basically, racing is his life. That's what his passion is, and maybe he just saw it fit to share it with his children. Now, I can see why he did that, because he probably knew that his son was going to follow in his steps. So his son probably didn't see that when he was younger, but in time, he became really good at it.
And he actually ended up becoming a racer himself.
Right.
So, during a lot of the race scenes, they use actual footage from the real-life events that happened, captured by ESPN themselves. So, and one scene that specifically stuck out to me is when they used real-life footage of a car crashes that Dale has done throughout his career. And I'm pretty sure they used the one that killed him.
Mm-hmm.
That was a bit of a what the frick moment to me. Pretty weird.
It does seem kind of morbid, but it is basically talking about his life, so I mean, might as well throw that in there. If you're going to put a biography into the movie, might as well show some actual footage of what was going on.
But the thing is that it's so obvious that it's past footage. Like, it doesn't clash with the footage from the movie at all. Like, oh, you can clearly tell that this footage is from the early 2000s and this footage is from the mid-80s. It's so obvious and so bad, really. Want to talk about the acting?
Well, I think the dialect was pretty cool, like how they actually weren't afraid to display the accent. There was a lot of words that
a lot of rednecky sounds.
Yeah, it's just a lot of what they call twang. And I just thought that was really interesting. But the acting portrayed a cycle. Like, I pointed that out, like, in the beginning where his father told him that other things prioritize before racing. Racing isn't just completely your life. You need to think beforehand and get involved in other things that can help you support your life or your family before racing. Racing is
what Dale is it? Ends up, And Dale ends up saying the exact same thing to his son later on in the movie.
Right. And both find out that they are wrong and that what their father had said was right.
Yes. Most of the acting, I feel, is a bit mad to just flat out bad. Like, mainly some of the one-offs, I'm like, you could have taken another take there. Well, clearly the best actor is the only one that I recognized. J.K. Simmons is great, as always. And as we said, he's barely in the movie. He's, like, 20 minutes in, they kill him off. And he shows up very, very briefly at the end of the movie. And would we like to talk about the ending or focus on some other things first?
Well, first, who's your favorite character?
Well, technically none of these are characters. They were real people. I mean,
who was your favorite person?
J.K. Simmons.
Okay.
Because it's J.K. Simmons, and how can you not like J.K. Simmons?
Well, I mean, my favorite person portrayed in the movie was Neil.
Mm.
Which is actually quite shocking, because I'm not the kind of person to like the more static rather than dynamic characters, but I liked Neil because I thought he was pretty interesting. And maybe he might have been an extremely interesting person in real life, but I was actually really shocked when I saw what happened in the movie.
Now, talk about the music real quick. The music is a bit half and half. Some of it sounds like real movie music, something you would see in a big Disney movie. Well, this isn't a big Disney movie, but, you know. And the other half of it feels like stock, generic type of music that you would hear in one of my videos, or literally anywhere on YouTube. Basically some royalty-free public domain music. like there was one scene, like, during, like, a racing scene, I believe it was. And the music sounded so generic. I feel like
I couldn't point out any copyrighted music, not that I know of. I'm sure if I Shazammed some, I could probably find some, but...
Maybe they played some Footloose in there somewhere, I don't know. So, you ready to talk about the ending?
We can, but before that, I actually have a cool little fact for you about this.
Ooh! Facts.
So, you know how one of his nicknames was the Intimidator?
Yes, I do.
There is actually a roller coaster built in Carowinds in North and South Carolina called the Intimidator. And
named after him?
Right. It was named after him.
Ah!
It began in the summer of 2009, and it is open in Carowinds, and I personally wrote it, and I didn't know about the guy beforehand.
Neither did I. I did not know he was named after that roller coaster.
I remember
writing. I enjoy the Intimidator. I think it's a good coaster, and I bet half of the people watching this don't know what we're talking about.
Probably not. But if you do go to Carowinds, make sure you look out for that ride. It's actually a really awesome experience.
Those of you who don't know, Carowinds is an amusement park in North Carolina. That's owned by Cedar Point, the same company that owns Knott's Berry Farm, and they even have a Camp Snoopy there. So. There you go. Basically, it's Knott's Berry Farm with less theming.
Amazing rides.
Yes. So, now let's get to talking about the ending. So, the film... So, as I said at the beginning, Dale Earnhardt died while he was racing in a car accident.
Did you say Ernstein?
Ernstein?
Earnhardt.
I'm sorry. So Dale Earnhardt died in 2001 in a car accident while racing. So this movie portrays it, but they just show him crashing. Then we cut back to a flashback of him as a kid. His dad picks him up, hugs him. Roll credits!
Well, he also kisses him.
Ah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. But, yeah, roll credits. The movie just ends on that. We don't see him in the hospital or anything, or, like, his funeral. So it's implied that he dies. They don't outright state it.
Maybe they're trying to intrigue people to do a little more research. Maybe look up some photos or maybe something that has to deal with his death.
But what you do in a biography is that you tell a person's life.
Basically. But he's dead. You can't, like, he's dead. It's no longer life. It is death.
A person's history.
There you go. That's the exact definition.
Yes.
So, it does end very abrupt, and I was kind of disappointed at, it just did end very quickly. I do think that the scene at the end where he is picked up by his father and is giving him a kiss is not only just for show, but also symbolism, as that his he's accepted his work. His father is proud of him for his work.
Ah.
Yes, that is what I saw.
I took it as he's seeing his dad again.
Well, yeah.
Just because he's going to die.
Yeah. But there's a huge symbol of acceptance in that end that I saw. And that probably very interesting to see. I liked how they showed his death throughout the movie, like, as he's having, like, visions of how he dies.
Yeah, it was foreshadowed throughout the movie, and I'm pretty sure they used real footage from the actual crashing.
Probably.
Pretty morbid. It's like in JFK, where they use actual footage of his assassination.
Mm-hmm.
Which, or in Game of Death, where they use real footage from Bruce Lee's funeral.
Mm-hmm.
So, anyway, now that it's all said and done, we've given our opinions. What would you rank this movie? Would you give it a golden castle or a giant Pooh Bear?
Aren't those both really good things, though?
Pooh Bear is in a piece of poop.
Oh, see,
get Pooh Bear. It'll be very funny for when we do a Winnie the Pooh movie later on.
Since this is Disney themed, I thought both of those were sunshine lollipops, but honestly, if I were to give it on a number scale, which is more relevant and something I can stick to, I'd give it probably a 7 or an 8.
Or would you give it the castle or the poo?
A castle.
Alright. I think I would go ahead and give it the golden castle too. Now, these movies really aren't made for me, but I can definitely see someone enjoying it, and overall I think it's a well-made movie overall. It's a decent sports drama, and I can see people really enjoying it. Right. So that will be it for this episode. Katie, thank you so much for joining me on this video, episode. If you guys did enjoy it, please let me know. And, I don't know what to say. And be sure to check out the previous episode and all the other episodes coming soon. And if you're watching this on YouTube, please leave a like and subscribe to be notified on when future episodes will come out. And be sure to join us next time when we will be talking about the late 90s Touchstone Pictures classic? I don't know. The Sixth Man. Anyway, we'll see you later. Bye!